Departures. I found it lying on the balcony. I could see that it was still alive. I've got it in a box. The thing is, Paul, I have no idea what to do with it, but I don't want to let it die. I see. Do you know what species it is, Renos? I don't know. It's black with a white throat, long wings. Oh no, Paul thought. A swift. It is almost impossible to feed a baby swift. It's sure to die. Aloud he said. Sounds like a swift. Difficult. Look, I'm sorry to bother you, but I don't know anyone in Greece who is interested in birds. Yes, thought Paul. It does seem crazy for a man in Athens to be phoning someone in London about a baby bird. Aloud he said, why don't you put it back in the nest? I've looked and I can't find the nest. What shall I do? Paul thought to himself, let it die. But he knew he could not say that. Keep it warm and feed it with tiny pieces of cat food. How do I get the food down its throat? How often should I feed it? Does it need water too? Paul answered Renaud's questions as best he could. Thanks a lot, Paul. I'll phone you again to let you know how things are going. Best of luck, Renaud. Mary Jean looked at the skinny thing in the box. What an ugly bird. What is it? It's a swift. I found it on the balcony. I'm trying to feed it. Mary Jean shrugged her shoulders. A waste of time, if you ask me. She watched the loving way in which Renaud held the tiny bird in his hand while he fed it. She suddenly felt angry again. The same anger that she had felt the other night. I'm going. What? I thought we were going out together this evening. Forget it. I can see you are much too busy. The door slammed as she left. He fed the swift and thought about Mary Jean. He was fond of Mary Jean, but did he really love her? And did she really love him? They seemed to fight a lot. But maybe that was a sign that they did love each other. They had met in July. She had come over from the States to spend the summer studying ancient Greek architecture. She had talked about staying on after the summer. The bird was having difficulty in swallowing the cat meat. Hello, Paul. It's me again. Hello, Renaud. How's the bird? Not good. It won't eat. It spends most of its time sleeping. Well, don't be upset if the bird doesn't make it. Swifts eat insects and that makes them difficult to feed. Now, if it ate seeds like a goldfinch, say, it's not a goldfinch, Renaud retorted. Sorry, Paul. Look, I really need your help. Try feeding it on fish soaked in milk. Mary Jean came round 3 days later. Renaud was still nursing the tiny bird. I'm going, Renaud. I've had enough. What? He had hardly noticed her standing there. The door slammed as she left. Paul, bad news. I'm afraid. It died this morning. Sorry. Thanks for your help anyway. He went out onto the balcony and looked up into the evening sky. There were swifts flying around everywhere. Above them, high in the sky, a Boeing 747 was winging its way west. In seat 14D, an American student of ancient Greek architecture was settling down for her return flight to New York.
Thank you for attending this session. Do share and subscribe to this channel for more lessons like this. Check out other video lessons by clicking on the video.